That's the first challenge, is getting a good takeoff. That was probably the hardest thing about learning to ride this bike, was balancing and looking out toward the horizon to keep the balance while starting it. Just like anything else with practice, it's become much easier. Bit of a wind today. It'll be a good test for this little microphone. See if it actually helps. It has a seat is stationary. As you can see, the pedals slide. It's a sliding rigger. Cut back on the oscillation that you would have with a sliding seat. So if you have to compare the rowing bike to the road bike, the road bike was invented by the same guy that ran rollerblade. The rowing bike, this one, is gonna give you probably more speed and more efficiency. There'll also be less wind resistance, and that you are in more of a lean back position. Now, this particular rowing bike was made in the late 90s. The Thys. THYS. The inventor of this particular model of bike, rowing bike, is a guy named Dirk Thys, who was in the recumbent bike business and kind of broke away from that company. A company called M5 that made really fast recumbent bicycles. He broke away with them to pursue his dream of making rowing bikes. And the recumbent bike and the rowing bike has a much bigger following in his native land, which is in the Netherlands. So if I were to start doing something like that, I'd probably have to look at putting a 21-speed hub on here. Something that would give me lower gearing. If they still do it, but they were having an annual kind of like a worldwide competition where people would come from all over to the Netherlands to participate in it was like a 3 or 4 day challenge, when they did like marathon races and sprints and all different kind of events with the rowing bike. Now, this rowing bike originally had a chain and sprocket set up. I have since replaced the sprocket with one of those multi-speed bicycle hubs, which made shifting and hill climbing much smoother. Now, this is a steel bike. The steel bike with 27-inch wheels. the new bike has a carbon fiber frame, and it actually has a smaller wheel in the front. I think it's like a 26 inch rear and 20 inch front wheel, which would probably improve safety. The new bike also has no chain. It actually has something called a sneck, which is where the diama, that's the cord, actually wraps around the sneck and provides the differentials for the gearing. I've never actually tried anything like that, but from what the Dirt Thee says, is that it's a much better system for the row bike, the rowing bike. I have the 8-speed hub on this one, and for the hills that I have, I usually don't ride this anywhere but on my circuit here, Bowtie Loop. It's like a 2.25 mile double loop that I spend most of my time with the road bike on. And the hills here don't get that steep. Probably the steepest is maybe a 5% grade. So the 8-speed hub works great here. But it would probably be insufficient for a more challenging, you know, say a 10% or 12% grade. And then the other, another issue with this bike, it did have a rearview mirror, which I snapped off, and it would go right next to the Garmin there. You'd have to hold it and hold your bars right about here to be able to check it, but it was better than nothing. It's better than what I'm doing now. Now I'm just listening really for traffic behind me, staying over to the right as much as I can. The only reason why I like being in the middle here is because the road on the right side is really bumpy right through here. So I'm just really trying to save myself from some brain rattle. Otherwise, I'd be all the way over. Because I really don't like to be rely on listening for cars. It's with the wind and the noise of the bike. I don't always hear, especially the quieter vehicles. Anyhow, that's pretty much one full lap around my 2.25 mile track. If you have any questions about the rowing bike, just leave me a, drop me a line in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to answer anything you might have a question about. Until next time, have a great day, and I hope to see you out on the roads of Texas.